Doctors strive each and every day to make accurate diagnoses so that patients can feel better and improve their quality of life. Unfortunately, many patients find themselves in a vicious merry-go-round. They're feeling symptoms that are very real, but not getting the answers they need. This cycle can sometimes go on for months, even years. My next guest knows too well what that feels like. She is 13-year-old Carol Ann Pollard, and her mother is with her today, Allison. Also joining us this morning is Dr. Anastasia Catani, Medical Director for Salveo Diagnostics. Dr. Catani will be sharing a new tool that is helping doctors and patients get to the root cause of these symptoms and lead them to the right path to good health. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Mom, let me start with you. You noticed something was going on with Carol Ann at the age of 11. What happened?
Carol Ann was in fifth grade and she didn't want to leave me. We would drive to school in the morning and she would start crying and was unable to stop crying for hours, sometimes 2 or 3 hours of tears that no matter what I did, I couldn't help her stop the tears until finally the tears would run its course and she would fall asleep for the rest of the afternoon.
And this just started out of a sudden?
Sort of out of the blue, just out of the blue. And she was unable to go to school for the last month. We had to pull her out of school because she simply couldn't leave my side at that point.
And she wasn't like that before?
Not at all. She was a normal kid who loved to play outside and loved to ride her horse and did all kinds of things that regular 11-year-olds do.
Caroline, can you describe what you were feeling? The anxiety, what was it, sweetheart?
My hands would get really shaky really fast. My heart would start pounding. I would get sweaty, sometimes nauseous. And then I was try to rub the energy through my hands onto my knees.
How did this affect you as the months progressed growing up?
I didn't really play outside at all like I normally did.
Oh.
I didn't play with my friends, and normally when I go to the barn, I'm super happy before and after, but I'd be sad when I got in the car and almost normal when I got to the barn and rode. And once I would leave, I would be sad again. And it almost started to feel like a normal for me.
Dr. Catani, let me bring you in. I understand Mom reached out to you.
Yes, she did.
She was desperate, wasn't she?
She was. I was at a Christmas party that she was attending, and she broke down in tears because she didn't know what to do for her. She had gone through all the traditional paths and thought, well, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing, but she's not getting any better.
And when you started looking into it, were you seeing that there was a problem?
Oh, significantly, yes. I was able to talk to Carol Ann and examine her, and I realized that there's more here than meets the eye. There's definitely a problem.
So how do we get to the root of the problem, doctor?
Well, Hippocrates stated that all disease begins in the gut, and we're finding out that he's right in that poor gut health is at the root of many chronic diseases. So what we have designed are now tools that allow us to look at the gut even more deeply than previously to get to the root of the problem. In Carol Ann's case, we did a gut health stool assessment and we also did blood work. We found that she not only had a bacterium in her gut, which was creating a tremendous amount of inflammation, but we also found a condition known as hyperpermeability. And what that is, it's where there is a leakiness between the cells that line her digestive tract. And when that happens, many other things occur. For example, you cannot absorb nutrients and vitamins properly, and you also need those things for the development of neurotransmitters, because our gut is actually acting as a second brain. Those neurotransmitters are the chemicals that not only relay information in our brain, but they also help to define our mood and emotions. And a great portion of those are created in the gut.
Why aren't doctors performing these type of tests that seem to be giving answers?
These tests rely on new technology that requires some education. So we are passionate about educating providers to get to the root cause of chronic diseases. Patients go to their healthcare providers all the time with symptoms such as migraine headaches, fatigue, muscle aches, depression and anxiety, and they don't always get better. We need to look deeper into why people are experiencing these symptoms. And by looking deeper, we can actually fix the problem and give them real healing.
Carol Ann, I want to end with you. How are you doing today?
Much better.
Oh, I'm so happy to hear that. You're 13 now?
Yes.
Back in school?
Not yet.
Not yet. Going soon?
Yes.
All right. And tell me maybe some things that you're doing that maybe you weren't doing before.
Playing with my friends. I'm more independent, and I'm just much more happy in myself. Feel normal again.
And Mom, thank you for sharing her story, and hopefully it can help somebody out there who may be going through the same thing.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it. Dr. Catani, do appreciate everything you're doing. For our viewers out there who'd like more information, where do they go?
SalveoDiagnostics.com.
All right. And of course, if you'd like more information on Salveo Diagnostics, check out our website, TheBalancingAct.com.